How conductive is conductive filament? Can a CHEP cube become a resistor? Let's find out on today's Filament Friday. This video is sponsored by PCBWay.com. This video is also brought to you by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. You can get conductive filament pretty much anywhere, but I've had a spool of protoposter for a while, so I figured I'd use that. To make conductive PLA, they just mix plastic with carbon, the same stuff that they use to make resistors. So really, it's just resistive material. So how resistive is conductive PLA? The specs are specified as resistance per centimeter. So in the X and Y direction, 30 ohms per centimeter. In the Z direction, 115 ohms per centimeter. But I'm not really sure how they measure it, so I just decided to do my own measurements on my own 3D prints. I searched around for some conductive test prints, but I couldn't find any good ones. So I just thought, why not just do some strips and measure with an ohm meter? So I decided to just go into Tinkercad and make some strips of my own. The first one is 1 millimeter wide by 1 millimeter tall. The next one is 2 millimeters wide by 1 millimeter tall. And then I made a 3 millimeter wide, a 4 millimeter wide, and a 5 millimeter wide, and all of them are 100 millimeters long. I brought that into Cura and realized I could change the thickness just by adjusting the Z height without uniform scaling. I can go right up to 5 millimeters, so I could make 5 millimeter by 5 millimeter blocks. And then I realized I probably need a special profile to slice this. So I made a conductive profile based on my good profile at a 0.2 layer height. I'm only going to use one wall for this print, and I'm also going to do no top or bottom layers. I'm going to use 100% infill with lines, and then I'm going to rotate them 90 degrees to each other so they cross and connect each other like wires. This filament also requires a little higher temperature, so I'm going to use 215 degrees. I slice it, and it says 13 minutes to print the 1 millimeter tall version. If we look at the preview, you can see it's going to print lines horizontally, and the next layer is going to print short little lines perpendicular to it to connect those lines. The thought is it will make connections from side to side to wire, so everything is connected as one piece of conductive plastic all the way across the 3D print. I wanted to measure 20 millimeter wide cross sections for resistance. So to be consistent, I made a jig to hold my probes. Back to Tinkercad, I made a plate with two 9.5 millimeter holes. This should fit the probes, and they're exactly 20 millimeters apart. So just group this together and print it out. And here it is, and it fits perfectly first try. I did 5 different prints. This one's the 4 millimeter tall. I did a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I'm testing the 5 millimeter wide strip by just pressing hard to get rid of contact resistance, 570 ohms. 4 millimeters wide is 606 ohms. 3 millimeters wide is around 800 ohms. 2 millimeters wide measures 900 ohms. And 1 millimeter wide is like 1.5K. I did it multiple times and took the averages, and then I plotted them. And this is the result. The heights are in color. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The top is the colored lines, and on the bottom is the width, and the side is the resistance. And you can see as the cross-sectional area gets bigger, 5 by 5 is the least amount of resistance. 1 by 1 is the highest. Now, resistance is actually measuring how hard it is for electrons to get through the conductor. Now, electrically, it makes sense that the bigger cross area would reduce the resistance. Think of it this way. 1 millimeter by 1 millimeter is like one ticket booth at a sporting event. If everyone had to go through that one ticket booth, there'd be a lot of resistance. There'd be a lot of backup of people trying to squeeze through there. But if instead you spread it out, so you have 5 ticket booths, just like 5 millimeters, now more people can get through faster. What if you put 1 or 5 ticket booths on every level of a 5-story parking garage? 5 by 5, that's 25 ticket booths. People are going to get through much easier. And then you're going to reach a point where you got so many ticket booths that there's not enough people to go through. And that's the same thing with electrons. There's only so many free electrons, and they'll go through, and then it's going to level off, which is kind of what we saw at the 4 to 5 millimeter square cross section. Since I'm probing at 20 millimeters, I wondered what a 20 millimeter by 20 millimeter by 20 millimeter print would be in resistance. Well, that's a CHEP cube. So let's print a CHEP cube in conductive filament and see how much resistance it is. I loaded a CHEP cube into Cura, and I'm going to use that same conductive profile to slice it. And it said it would take 42 minutes to print, again 100% infill. And here it is, the lines are going to cross back and forth all the way through. You can see back and forth. So it printed pretty nicely. So now we can actually probe this thing and see how much resistance it is. And I'm going to do that on the bottom. So here's my probe. I touch it and I'm getting about 1K, but it's dropping. It's going to level out to about 850 ohms. If you want to light an LED, you typically need a series resistance to limit the current. If you're running at 5 volts, you tend to use a 300 or 330 ohm resistor. If you're running at 12 volts, you need about 800 to 1K. So since this measured about that range, let's see if we can use this as a resistor to light an LED. So I made this simple breadboard circuit. Current's going to flow through the LED, across the CHEP cube, and then back to ground. I got the power supply set to 12 volts. I got two probes to hold the CHEP cube. So I'll put the CHEP cube on top. And look at that, the LED lights. Here's a close-up. I touch it, the LED lights. I take it off, the LED goes off. I added a post so I could just rest the CHEP cube on it because contact resistance can affect things. So here it is resting there. The harder I press, I reduce the contact resistance and the LED gets brighter. Now what would you use this for? Well, you could make your own stylus. Now this is a small one, so the resistance is going to be higher. And I can draw a little bit. Once in a while something appears on my phone. But to really get it to work consistently, I need the bigger one, which has less resistance. So 5x5. Now I can actually draw right on my phone. So could you use this conductive filament to make a circuit board? Nah, I wouldn't recommend it. For that, I recommend PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com is a great place to get circuit boards. I use them all the time. You can get 10 pieces for only $5 plus shipping. Or if you want assembly, you can get assembly services for a low cost. And it doesn't stop there. They offer CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding. Ordering circuit boards is easy. Just upload your Gerber files and then go through their selection menu. And you can just go with the defaults, or you can do things like change the board color. And then you order them, they'll ship them out to you, top quality. I highly recommend PCBWay.com. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up. If you want to help support the channel, Patreon's one way. If nothing else, click on that Filament Friday logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time, right here at Filament Friday.